Evening all. Little project on tonight. At the rally yesterday, picked up a few odds and sods, and including these wheels. Quite nice big wheels, probably what are they, 10, 11 inch diameter. Wide as well, so whatever I put on those wheels won't sink into the mud too easily, and that's handy in the garden here. With the pond next door, it gets quite boggy, so that'll be good. I'm hoping to use these with a little Bernard WO I'm getting next week, or this week hopefully, once I've arranged the shipping. It's in a bit of a state, it needs new main bearings, push rods made, that sort of thing. So that's going to be a nice long term restoration. Funnily enough, I've actually got a magneto there for one of those, which I'm rebuilding at the moment. Keep that as a spare. So that's what I'm hoping to use these wheels for, WO, so it's not going to have a very heavy engine on it, probably 70, 80 kilos, maybe if that. And what I'm planning to do, because the hubs of these are in a bit of a state, been knocked about, they were probably on an old shepherd's hut or something. What I'm hoping to do is bush them with a bit of this iron bar, and then bore these out, so I've got an inside diameter of about 21 mil. So there'll be a nice rolling fit on 20mm steel bar. So that's the plan. I'm going to use the old Dremond lathe for that. And I've just bought a new rotating centre for that. Which is just, it just helps increase the accuracy of the work. Yesterday I also picked up some quite large spanners. Useful for flywheel nuts, that sort of thing. Another oil can. The collection, and some old screwdrivers, which are always good to have, all for a quid. So that's tonight's project. Just working on the bushings for these wheels again. I've just machined this little bit of bar down to 31mm, which is the bore size. It's been bored right through, and what I'm going to do, I decided to save on material because these wheels are not going to carry a heavy load. I'm just going to make four spaces out of this, well, four little bushings, and two of them will be used for each wheel. One pushed in at each end, and there'll be a bit of tube in the middle between the two, which will keep them spaced. I thought I don't actually need to use all that bar for each wheel, it's just not necessary. So save on material and machining time. So the next job is to part that off. I'm going to cut that into the sizes I need and then bore each of them out to about 20.5mm. Just larger than the bar, so it's a good rolling fit. Evening all. Finally finished these wheels now. Just to sort of recap, I'm going to use these for a little Bernard WO, small petrol stationary engine, probably weighing about 75-80 kilos, little French engine, not very heavy, and but I decided to use these wheels that I picked up at the weekend. You know, I think they'll look quite nice. So I figured that the 1¼-inch bore, you know, we wouldn't need axles that big, and that would make the bearing blocks very expensive as well. So to keep the cost down and the weight as well, I've reduced them from 1¼ to 20mm centres. Used a bit of this steel bar, and what I've done, I made these little bushings, two of them for each one, and they're about 9-10mm wide, and they were a tight press fit in there. So what I did, heated up the bore, and then using a drift there, just knock them in. Now I don't know if you can see, but in the centre there, there's a little bit of tube. That's going to stay there. bit of alloy tube, and I've put that in the middle to keep them spaced so they can't move. They shouldn't move, they're that tight anyway, but I just thought I'd put that in there. It keeps them true then. So I'm quite pleased with that. That was the better wheel, in much better condition. This one was quite bad. So what I've had to do here is sink these in deeper, obviously so there's enough meat to hold them in there. I'll probably make up some sort of little spacer that will run in front of that, and then a washer can go in front once it's on the trolley. Might even just be able to make one that sits in there, and then we split pin in front of it. That won't be any bother then. But yeah, for the money these wheels cost, they are incredibly cheap. So it's worth using them, just worth the time to resurrect them. Yeah, quite pleased with that. So I'll go and put them on the axles in a minute, just show you. I was using the old Drummond lathe for this, old round bed lathe. And created plenty of swarf. So there you go. There we are, so a bit of 20mm steel bar. And that one's quite tight on there. It does spin freely if you hold the bar. That's quite a good fit. This one's slightly freer. But again, it's not sloppy at all. Should do the job nicely. So the next steps, I'll probably pressure wash those, take them into work with me one afternoon. If we get a quiet patch, I can do that. And then prime them, paint them. Yeah, so I hope that was of some interest, and thanks for watching.